Hey, Momentum Makers, I'm Emily.
And I'm Brooke. And today we're going to talk to you about
cost. It's too expensive, right? I told her that for a month.
Yeah.
And it was.
Yeah, exactly.
Because I didn't see value.
No, you didn't see value in it. And I know that there are thousands of you guys out there that are struggling with this very objection. You cannot get people off the fence. Every single person is telling you it's too expensive. And I remember getting that excuse. And I remember also thinking that even though I did have the money, I felt like, oh my gosh, I'm asking these people to spend $100, $150. Like, that's a lot of money. Mm-hmm. Because even though I had that money, I had never spent that kind of money on myself.
Well, a lot of people don't have these products budgeted, right, into their life, right? I mean, you have gas, you have food, you have rent. Those things are pretty basic. But then when you're trying to sell a product to someone, it might not be a product that they're already using in their life, right? I mean, yes, if they're switching from one thing to another, that's a different story. But most of the time in our experience, we're asking someone to add something into their budget that they don't currently have there, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. So the biggest thing that I just want to tell you, first of all, is the way you posture yourself is going to determine the outcome, right? Yeah. If you are like, so I know it's kind of expensive, but I really think you'll love that. No, okay? You need to focus on, hey, I found something really great that I think you're going to see value in, mm-hmm. and I'm so excited to tell you about it. And it's using, called, yeah. Have you heard of it before?
And using things like, it's so affordable. Like, instead of saying, oh my gosh, it's kind of expensive, can you have the confidence to say, for what it is, it's incredibly affordable. I actually can't believe how good the price is. That is truly what I feel. I'm like, $99? Oh my gosh, this is so affordable for everything you're gonna get. Now, here's a great example. My father-in-law is a cosmetic dentist, okay? And he works in an area where people predominantly do not have a lot of money, but he's a cosmetic dentist. And he does $50,000 full mouth makeovers that people that maybe don't really have that kind of money will pay for, because he sits down with them and he consults with them and he talks about how they're going to feel when they're able to smile and they're going to have beautiful teeth and they're going to be able to chew their food and not have a sore mouth or whatever it is. Are you building that value into the product when you're talking about it? For example, are you just giving them facts? Or are you sharing with them stories of people that are just like them? Are you using verbiage like, I am so excited to see you get relief from X, Y, and Z. I used to struggle with that too, and I used to spend money on X, Y, and Z, like all these different things that weren't working for me. So I cannot wait to see what this does for you. It's all about, when we say building the value, we mean like, we're showing them, this is what you're gonna feel like. This is what you're gonna look like. This is how your body's gonna work. You're gonna just, you gotta paint that picture for them so that when it comes to cost at the very end, you're like, it's actually super affordable.
And you guys, you're connecting, mm-hmm. right? There that word is again. You're not convincing, yeah. You're connecting, right? And so when you're coming in from that angle, you're basically working backwards to forwards. Mm-hmm. You're building the bridge the right direction. Then you can't go wrong. And I know sometimes it's really, really tempting to do the, I need some help reaching a goal type of thing. Please don't do that.
Don't right? Do it.
Because what's in it for them? It comes off as very selfish, mm-hmm. right? So again, you're not creating connection when you come in from, I need you to do me a favor. It would mean everything to me if I could hit this goal and you could just give me your money so that I can have the orders that I need.
Definitely right? Doesn't help with the cost objection.
Oh.
Right? So what are some other ways that you overcome cost objection with people?
Well, I mean, always this is a great opportunity to bring up the business, right? Mm-hmm. And even though you know that they're not looking for a network marketing opportunity, right? Not even knowing that, yes. You can still present it to them with, not to do a business, but gosh, to make your trial period free, if you were to start with three people who might also need more energy, better sleep, little bit of weight loss, or whatever it is you're talking to them about, it would be so great if they could join with you, because then you get a whole trial period for free and they're getting healthy with you at the same time. A lot of times I'll also bring up my best friend that I had tried to get to do the business with me from the very beginning. And she's the friend that I've done everything with my whole entire life. If I would go to join a gym tomorrow, I would be calling her and she would laugh because she knows I'm not a huge gym person. But I would say to her, I need you to come do this with me so I don't quit. I want to get healthy together. It'll be fun because we can like run on the treadmill together. We can talk, we can visit, and it will keep me accountable. It's just like that. I'm not waiting to get a 6-pack of abs before I tell my best friend to join with me. I'm asking her to start out of the gate with me because I know I'm going to be more successful and it's good for her too. That's exactly what you're asking people to do when you start this business with them as well. So don't like avoid bringing that up with them, because when you start opening people's minds and helping them to see it from a different perspective, they're going to go, oh
yeah,
maybe that makes sense. Call my mom.
Yeah.
That's not a bad idea.
Because it doesn't feel like a business.
Right.
But it's helping them to overcome the cost objection. I know for a lot of people that I've helped, you know, as I'm talking to them, building that relationship, getting to know them, I'm like the queen of asking questions.
Yes.
I always tell people, like, be curious about people. Ask more questions. Find out what their life is like. Find out what their habits are like. Do they have a couple gym memberships they don't go to? Are they going through a drive-through 5 days a week? Are they so tired that they can't make dinner for their kids, so they're taking them through the Chick-fil-A drive-through? Are they drinking a case of Diet Coke every 3 days? What are they doing in their life that they're spending money on that is not enhancing their life or adding any value to their life? So a lot of people, I've had that discussion with them where I'm like, you know, right now, you're probably spending about $150 on junk food, soda, energy drinks, Starbucks, all these other things. What if we took that $150 in your budget and we shifted it into something that made you feel amazing? Something that gave you the energy to actually make some dinner at home, or gave you the energy so that you didn't need the Starbucks and you didn't need the Red Bull and all these other things. I have no doubt that when you put this into your life, you're not even gonna want that stuff. And you're gonna feel so much better, and you're gonna believe that this is worth every single penny, because that's what happened for me. So that's how I'll talk to people about it. If they, you know, people have habits.
I'm sold. I'm sold.
We all have habits. Like, literally, the part about like kids and having to feed them, I got 6 kids, and I remember so many days I would be so tired. I would be so unmotivated. I'd be like, let's go to the McDonald's drive-thru. Every time I went to the McDonald's drive-thru with 6 kids, like $50. Mm-hmm. And so people are spending money. Don't be afraid to talk about that with people and to show them the vision of like, wow, I mean, what would it be like if you didn't have to go there? I mean, not only would you save money and feel better, but you'd probably lose that 20 pounds that you told me you want to lose. So let's do this. Let's get you started. And I think the other thing in overcoming money, like you were talking about, is confidence. Like, how passionate are you with people that they need this? Or as soon as they give you an objection, are you like, I think I'll just go crawl into a corner, right? Mm-hmm. It's like, if you are on fire and passionate about it and like, you need this, this is gonna change your life. Like, people are drawn to confidence and to passion, and people need you to tell them what to do.
They do, right? You guys, like, there were so many times when I was telling Brooke no, 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 but inside I was like, please somebody help me.
Right.
Like, just like, don't give up on me, please, mm-hmm. because I need saving.
Yeah.
Right? And everybody feels that way in some way or another in their life. Be that person for someone. Be that ripple. Don't just back down. Have a backbone. Believe in what you're sharing with them, and don't give up so easily.
Absolutely. All right, guys.